In the dissection of the anterior abdominal wall, we have given an straight incision from the xiphoid process to the pubic symphysis from above downward, keeping the umbilicus as a landmark and the umbilicus which lies at the level of L3 and L4. And we have also given an horizontal incision, and this straight and this horizontal incision that has divided this outer part into the four quadrant. The outermost part, this is the skin. You can clearly see this is the skin. We have reflected the skin. And deep to the skin lies the superficial fascia. This is the layer of the superficial fascia. And deep to the superficial fascia lies the muscles of the anterior abdominal wall. You can clearly see these muscles. This outermost muscle of the anterior abdominal wall, that is the external oblique muscle. And this external oblique muscle that is taking origin from the middle of the shaft of the lower eight ribs, from the outer surface of the lower eight rib. And it is directed downward, forward and medially. And the either side of the external oblique muscle, the aponeurosis of the both the side of the muscles meet in the midline as a lineal bar, that is the wide line. And this external oblique muscle that is getting inserted from above downward at the xiphoid process, lineal bar, pubic symphysis, lateral to the pubic symphysis lies the pubic crest. And from the pubic crest, laterally lies the pubic tubercle, and lateral to the pubic tubercle to this outer surface or the outer lip of the anterior two-thirds of the iliac crest. You can clearly see the direction of the fibers, that is running downward, forward and medially. And deep to the external oblique muscle lies the internal oblique muscle. You can clearly see the external that is running downward, forward and medially, and the internal oblique that is running upward and forward and medially. The direction of the external oblique muscle and the internal oblique muscle, it will intersect at the 90 degree. This is the rectus abdominis muscle. This muscle is the rectus abdominis muscle, and the lateral to the rectus abdominis muscle, here lies the linea semilunaris. And at the linea semilunaris, this internal oblique muscle, it will bifurcate into the anterior lamina and the posterior lamina, that will enclose the rectus abdominis muscle. You can clearly see this muscle, that is the rectus abdominis muscle, that is running vertically from below upward. This is the rectus abdominis muscle. This is external oblique, this is internal oblique, and at the linea semilunaris, this internal oblique, it will bifurcate and enclose the muscle that is the rectus abdominis muscle. And at the lower part of the rectus abdominis muscle, you can clearly see these are the vessels, these are the inferior epigastric vessels. These vessels are the inferior epigastric vessels. And deep to the internal oblique muscle, here lies the transversus abdominis muscle, which is running transversely. These muscle fibers are of the muscles of the transverse abdominis. And at the lateral aspect, and this is the lateral aspect, and at the anteriorly, the aponeurosis of the transversus abdominis run on the either side. And deep to the transversus abdominis lies the fascia transversalis. So from outwards to inward, the outermost layer, that is the skin. Deep to the skin lies the superficial fascia. Deep to the superficial fascia lies the external oblique. Deep to the external oblique lies the internal oblique. And at the linea semilunaris, it will bifurcate into the anterior lamina and the posterior lamina, enclosing the rectus abdominis muscle. Deep to the internal oblique lies the transversus abdominis. These are the aponeurosis of the transversus abdominis. Deep to the transversus abdominis, you can clearly see this fascia. This fascia is the fascia transversalis. This is the anterior abdominal wall. And deep to the fascia transversalis, here lies the peritoneum. You can clearly see deep to the this layer lies the extra peritoneal tissue, and deep to the extra peritoneal tissue lies the peritoneum. This is all about the anterior abdominal wall.